Many believe that rugby was born in 1823 when William Webb Ellis, with fine disregard for the rules of football as played in his time at rugby school, first took the ball in his arms and ran with it, thus originating the distinctive feature of the rugby game. Various early ball games were played during the Middle Ages, 5th to 16th century, and are sometimes referred to as folk football, mob football, or shrestified football. Such games would usually be played between neighboring towns and villages, involving a limited number of people on opposing teams who would fight and struggle to move the inflated pig's bladder by any means possible to markers at each end of the town. Authorities would later attempt to outlaw such dangerous, unprotective pastimes. The invention of rugby was therefore not the act of playing early forms of the game, or the acts of a certain Webb Ellis, whether his story is true or not, but rather the events which led up to its codification. Like so many sports which originated from Victorian England, it was competition, the sense of fair play, and the subsequent need for rules and laws which allowed the game to develop on a global basis and spawn internationally. The game of football was played at rugby school, Rugby England, between 1750 and 1823, permitted handling of the ball, but no one was allowed to run with it in their hands toward the opposition's goal. There was no fixed limit to the number of players per side, and sometimes there were hundreds taking part in a kind of enormous rolling maul. The innovation of running with the ball at rugby school was introduced sometime between 1820 and 1830. If William Webb Ellis was responsible for his innovation, as stated in Mr. Blocksman's account, it was probably met by vigorous retribution. But by 1838 to 1839, Jem Mackey, with his powerful running, made it acceptable a part of the game, although it was not legalized until 1841, initially by Big Slide Vevey, and finally by the first written rules of August 28, 1845. Rugby school, for example, developed rugby football from football and played this game according to rugby rules. The question as to why the game rugby became so popular in preference to the games of other schools, such as Eton, Winchester, or Harrow, was probably largely due to the reputation and success of rugby school under Dr. Arnold, and this also led most probably to its adoption by other schools. For in 1860, many schools besides rugby played football according to rugby rules. During the middle of 19th century, rugby football, up to that time a regular game only among schoolboys, took its place as a regular sport among men. The former students of rugby school and other rugby-playing schools such as Marlborough School started to spread their version of football far and wide. The notable first event was former pupil Arthur Pell, who founded a club at Cambridge University in 1839. In 1863, a meeting was held in Cambridge where a ban was placed on hacking, tripping, and Blackheath's preference, running with the ball in the hands toward the opposite goal after a fair catch. A separate meeting was also held in the Freemasons Tavern, Great Queen Street, London, with 11 schools and clubs supporting the kicking and handling codes present. They drew up common rules by which they could play each other. However, after they had reached a compromise, a number of attendees rechanted and ended up adopting the Cambridge rules, which precluded running with the ball. Blackheath subsequently withdrew from the Football Association, as it was then called. Henceforth, there was a split between association football, soccer, and rugby football, rugby. Even those who supported the rugby code were not in full agreement regarding the rules. Blackheath, for example, did not agree with hacking. A letter which appeared in the press in 1866 revealed that Richmond, a rugby club, also were wanting to remove this feature of the game. In the end, both clubs refused to play any team which supported hacking. The result was that hacking disappeared from club games, even though it remained at rugby school for a few seasons more. The Rugby Football Union was formed in 1871 and immediately made hacking and tripping illegal. Along with the founding of the Rugby Football Union, a committee was formed, and three ex-rugby school pupils, all lawyers, were invited to formulate a set of rules. Being lawyers, they formulated laws, not rules. This task was completed and approved by June 1871. The laws have changed a great deal since then and spawned other games, notably American football and Australian rules football.